Yes, my name is Rosaria Villari, but everybody call me Sara. I work at the ENEA Frascati Center in Italy, and I'm leading the water activation experiments within EUROfusion. And this is the one of the package of the technological experiments we are conducting at JET in preparation of ITER operation. Yes, it is an exciting experiment. We are studying the activation of water under neutron irradiation and the impact of the radiation field outside the main hall when the radioactive water flows out. In this experiment, we are measuring the short but intense gamma field from this activated water of one of the main jet cooling loop, and we want to correlate this with the plasma operation and with the circuits parameters. This will be extremely important because it will help to improve the knowledge on this very complex phenomena and to validate the theory and the computational tools which are used to simulate it. Let's consider that most of future fusion devices will use water for cooling the components which are close to the plasma. And when the water is exposed to these high energy neutrons, which are generated by the deuterium-tritium reaction, they become highly activated and emit mainly gamma radiation. This enormous burst of gamma is transported along the circuits. And even if it is at a short duration, this causes very high nuclear loads in sensitive tokamak and plants components. Let's imagine high nuclear heat in superconductive magnets or absorbed doses in the valves or high dose rate in electronics. The problem is that the mitigation of the effect requires the implementation of very expensive and massive shield to protect the sensitive system, or is necessary a complex relocation. However, the problem is that the models and the multiphysics tools which are used for the simulation have great uncertainties, and high safety factors are adopted in the design to ensure low risk. So this experiment will help significantly to validate the simulation data, improve the computational methodologies, and reduce the uncertainties. And this will have a significant impact on cost and design efforts to protect all sensitive systems. Imagine this is of paramount importance for both ITER, which is under construction in Cadarache, and also for future fusion power plants. We all know that JET is the most powerful fusion machine, and presently it is the only tokamak operating with tritium before ITER. So we have now the unique opportunity during DTE3 to study the phenomena in a real tokamak water cooling loop under high energy neutrons, which are generated by the deuterium-tritium reaction under the conditions which are more close to those real fusion power plants.